Good morning. Today topic of my presentation, Hawthorne study and Maslow hierarchy study. The Hawthorne study conducted by Elton Mayo and Fritz, an experiment at Hawthorne plant in Chicago, USA. The Hawthorne study as an attempt to find the relationship between lightning and energy or productivity of workers. After a careful three experiment related to the increase in the productivity of employees, the researchers concluded that employees would work harder if they believed management was concerned about their welfare and supervisors paid special attention to them. This phenomenon was subsequently labeled as the Hawthorne effect. The viewpoint of Hawthorne effect thus gave birth to human relations movement. The aim of this study was to study the effect of work environment, fatigue, rest pauses, hours of work, hours in the working week, monotony, money incentives, employees' attitude, employees' organization, leadership, etc. on the productivity. Mayo and his assistant set out to measure the effect of changes in working condition and other physical factors on the productivity of the workers. The five studies undertaken in this respect as: first one, experiment on illumination; second one, relay assembly test room; third one, mass interviewing program; and fourth one, book wiring observation room; fifth one, personal counseling. The main findings of the Hawthorne studies are: responsiveness to total work situation, social factors in motivation, significance of human group, leadership, supervision, communication and consultation. Responsiveness to total work situation, it means the experiment or study demonstrates that changes in working environment, rest pauses, hours of work, hours in the working week, fatigue, incentives, employees' attitude, employees' organization, both formal and informal employee and employer relations are all intimately related. Mayo and his associates stressed that workers should respond to their total work situation. Second one, social factors in motivation. It means according to Elton Mayo, and social factors had the greatest influence on willingness to work. He concluded that work satisfaction depends to a large extent on the informal social pattern of the work group, where norms of cooperativeness and high output are established because of a feeling of importance. Third one, significance of human group. The most significant discovery of Hawthorne experiment was extent of informal organization in all organizations. Informal relations have stronger influence than formal relationship. Fourth one, leadership. Elton Mayo advocated a change in leadership style. According to him, a leader must recognize the significance of group work. He must be able to understand the feelings and sentiments implied from the words and behavior of employer. Fifth one, supervision. Mayo observed that the workers would work more productively under friendly, cooperative and relaxed supervisor than an authoritarian one. Sixth one, communication and consultation. According to Mayo, workers must have given an opportunity to participate in decision making. They must be provided an opportunity to express their view, feelings and grievances. Hawthorne effect example, teaching. In teaching, it is common to see the Hawthorne effect in action. For instance, the teacher may know that they are being observed by the principal or head teacher, so make the extra effort on their lesson plan and performance. At the same time, the presence of the principal can have an effect on children's behavior. Knowing they are watching may provide an incentive for the children to behave in fear that they may be told off. Moving to the next topic, Maslow's hierarchy study. The behavioral scientists have made notable contribution in the field of management through their studies and researches in the field of group dynamic, human motivation and leadership. Maslow's contribution in the field of human motivation was a notable one. He wrote a book, Motivation and Personality, in 1954. He developed a need hierarchy theory to explain human behavior within an organization. He stressed that behavior of individuals was directed toward the satisfaction of need. He emphasized that human need could be arranged in a particular order from the lower level to higher level. Is this the pyramid of level of hierarchy? Physiological, safety, love and belonging, esteem, self-actualization. Physiological need. Physiological need are the lowest level of Maslow hierarchy of need. They are the most essential thing a person need to survive. They include the need for shelter, water, food, warmth, rest and health. A person's motivation at this level derive from their instinct to survive. Second one, safety need. The second level of Maslow's hierarchy of need consists of safety need. Safety or security need relate to a person's need to feel safe and secure in their life and surroundings. Third one, love and belonging need. The third level of Maslow hierarchy of need is love and belonging needs. Humans are social creatures that crave interaction with others. This level of the hierarchy outlines the need for friendship, intimacy, family and love. Fourth one, esteem need. The fourth level of Maslow hierarchy of need is esteem need. Esteem need are related to a person's need to gain recognition, status and feel respected. Fifth one, self-actualization need. The fifth and final level of Maslow hierarchy of need is self-actualization need. Self-actualization relate to the realization of an individual full potential. At this level, people strive to become the best that they possibly can be. Example of Maslow's hierarchy of need. If a person is lost in the woods, they are likely looking to fulfill their physiological need. They may be hungry, thirsty, lacking shelter, or cold. This individual would probably not be concerned with their financial security or their need to belong in a group. They are looking to fulfill the conditions for their immediate survival. Conversely, we can consider a senior financial analyst. This is someone who has a secure, high-paying job, a spouse, family, a house. This person is in a well-respected position at their company and among their peer. It is unlikely that this person's motivation focuses on their physiological or safety need, as these are clearly fulfilled. Instead, they would be looking to strive for personal growth and happiness. They would be looking to fulfill their self-actualization need or discover what else the world has to offer and what they have to offer the world. Thank you.